I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I am providing a detailed how-to guide on using TikZ and PGF plots. I'm a longtime user of these tools, so I understand your frustrations. We're working our way through the contents of my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, linked in the show notes. Today's topic is how to get line breaks inside TikZ nodes. Just adding a line break doesn't work by default. I covered two methods to fix this. One is using the align key with manual line breaks. The other is setting the text width, and you can also combine that with the align key. This will be a relatively quick lesson. I'm assuming you're already a little bit familiar with TikZ. If not, go back and watch at least my prior video introducing TikZ nodes, linked in the show notes. As usual, we'll go ahead and create our document over at overleaf.com so that you can follow along. We'll name this one Creating Line Breaks in TikZ Nodes. Let me get organized a bit by closing this left navigation and increasing the size of the PDF document. We'll add the usual packages up top. So let me add TikZ. We won't be using any special TikZ libraries today. We use Parskip and Full Page just to make things look nice. And Hyperref is so that the author name can link back to the YouTube channel. Before we start thinking about wrapping text in nodes, I'm going to change the default node style to make the text large and draw the outline of the node. So the way I'm going to do this is by specifying a TikZ set. I'm going to use the special key every node, which we talked about in the last episode linked in the show notes. I'm going to append its style to draw. That'll create the outline of every node, and I'll set the font style to large so that it was easier for us to see as we do our video today. So now I'm going to go ahead and paste a little example. So this is a node that says the quick brown fox jumped over the incredibly lazy dog. It is drawn the outline by default, and the text is large because I set up this every node up here. Now, suppose I wanted to break this up into three lines. So I might think I'll just add some line breaks in these two spots, and I'll recompile, and now it should have breaks. It doesn't work that way. So here we have fox jumped instead of a line break. It actually just took away all the space, and now these words are running together. So this is really not what we wanted at all. So how do we fix this? So let's go ahead and copy our previous bit of code, and we'll make some changes to that. So this is our code that's not working. And then I'm going to add an option to the node that is align equals left. And now when I recompile it, everything works as I had hoped. I have these manual line breaks inside my node here and here, and it breaks there because I specified align equals left. We can, of course, do right and center as well. So here we have right, and here we have center. And if we look over at the results, they're exactly as you would expect. The text is over to the right, or the text is in the center. Now, what if you want your lines to break automatically? So let's go back to our original example again and look at what we can do with alternative keys. So we can, instead of saying that we want to align, we can say what the text width is. So that will automatically determine the breaks to fit into 1.5 inches wide. So that is the width of the text in that node, no matter what, even if it doesn't go far enough to fill it up. By default, the alignment here is left. We can, of course, change that. I could combine this with align equals center, and then it will go ahead and center that text. Now, one thing you'll notice here is that incredibly is broken up. So that's fine, but maybe you're like, oh, I don't want my words to be broken. I want to do something that's kind of like a ragged type thing. So the way that you fix that, I'll go ahead and paste another example here, is you use flush left. So you can add flush in front of left, center, or right, and then it'll prevent words from breaking. So now incredibly is on its own word. You can also do, of course, flush center. So here's another example with flush center. And the flush is really only meaningful when combined with text width. You can use it when you do manual line breaks, but it's not going to really make any difference because you are manually breaking the lines. So flush center, flush left, and flush right are really only meaningful in combination with the text width modifier. There's one other align option that's really only meaningful with the text width, and that's justify. So again, if you manually break the lines, it won't justify that. But here I've used justify in this, and then it stretched out all the lines except for the last one so that they touch the right-hand side. This is a pretty narrow box, and there's not that many words, even with repeating it twice. but it kind of gives you an idea of how Justify works, and with wider boxes and smaller text, it looks a lot better. I hope you enjoyed today's video. We discussed how regular line breaks don't work by default, and we talked about two solutions for this. One solution is to specify a line to be left, center, or right, and put in manual line breaks. The other is to specify the text width along with optional align option. It defaults to left. You can specify center, right. You can also do justify, and you can add flush in front of center, left, or right. This is the second video in a sequence of videos on nodes, so be on the lookout for the next in the sequence. There's a link to the Overleaf document we created today in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. You can also buy my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, at your favorite book retailer. Thanks for watching.